Here's the picture of LaBamba going over a jump that I've decided to use as a pattern for Mason's rocking horse. And I've drawn an enlargement of it to use as a pattern.
The object in wood carving is that you start out with a big block of wood, and some of that wood is whatever you're carving, say a horse. But there's a lot of that wood that's not horse at all. So the horse is outlined in this black outline. So I've got to take away all the wood that's not horse. And I've taken off some here with the saw. And I already knocked a chunk out here with my pry bar and stuff. But this big chunk back here is not horse. All of this is not horse. And I can't just pry it off with the pry bar, so I've got to drive these wedges in it and break it out. I sawed down with the chainsaw here, but I want to break it out and get rid of it and get it out of there, so I've got to use these wedges to do that. That's what it works. Okay, there's a whole lot that's not even horse. See? I got rid of a bunch of wood that wasn't horse right there. And then I'll work on some more with the chainsaw now, and then I'll get my chisel and refine it and bring it down real fine. And here, this is going to be kind of tricky because I'm going to have to cut in here. There's a space between his tail and his back leg. And I don't know if I can do that with a chainsaw or not. I'll try to make a plunge cut with my chain. Here's my little carving saw. It's got a little 12-inch bar. And I think I can plunge cut. But I have to be real careful because doing that, it can kick back up in my face and cut me like it did before. But I do have a thing I wear for protection. And this will protect my ears from the sound, and this will protect my face. So then when I get in real close carving, if it kicks back, it'll hit this and it'll protect me. See if it'll pry. No. Okay, what I'm gonna have to do is cut on through here back a little
And I think I can get it out there if I kind of make a cut here. All twisted in there.
Yeah, you need to get this brace out, I guess.
Yeah, I'll have to take the...
That sure did it, though. That loosened it right up.
Go ahead. I'm gonna...
Okay.
If I get that other wedge out, then I can get my saw out of the way. Sometimes cutting big wood, get a wedge stuck in there. And you can't get it out even to get your saw out. Well, there's a nice big chunk that's not hoarse. Came down quite a bit. Now I can take this off. I'll do that with my smaller saw.
It's looking like a horse.
A horse, of course. Where does that go?
Unless, of
course...
A horse is a horse, of course. Unless...
But a horse is a horse, of course.
Unless his name is Mr. Ed. Or something. But it really is starting to look like a little horse instead of like a big clump of tree.
There's some gray wood in here. Look at this streak of gray. Beautiful colors, and then here's the red and white streaked in. Watch it take out this chip right here.
It changes color.
Yeah. Beautiful wood, goodness. See what?
A horse.
Oh, you begin to see the horse. Now there's more and more wood coming out that's not horse. See, here's his tail.
Yeah, I saw that.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
And his haunches here, his hind feet. Now, sometimes when they're jumping, one hip will be up higher than the other because they have the one leg raised up higher. And look at the front here, LaBamba, Dela's horse. I always noticed when he jumped, he would turn his nose to the side like this. I don't know why he did that, but every time he went over a jump, he'd have his nose turned a little to the side. Instead of being pointed straight ahead, he'd point it. It was probably the turn he was going to make. I bet that's what he was doing. Here he was going to be making a right turn, so he'd have his nose turned a little that way. I'll have to go back and watch the video. Probably when he had his nose turned to the left, he's probably going to make a left turn. So anyway, here he's making a right turn. This will be his mane up here.
What do you think, Caitlin? You think Mason will like it?
Mm-hmm.
I do too. I think Mason is going to love it.
How can you make it rock?
Oh, he's going to put rock, a thing on the bottom to make it rock. It's going to be it. This is just what Mason will be sitting on.
Look at here. Three different colors. The gray, the white, gray, and red. Going through all those different colors there. It'll almost be in his mane. Won't that be a pretty mane?
Yes.
Wow. Now, kind of leave the texture of the chisel in to make it look like his mane.
The chisel's what makes it look nice.
I know. And just Bub saw this horse inside that big block of tree trunk. All I saw was tree trunk. But Bub could see every bit of that. That's the artistic mind.
Yeah, I've cut some places that's my chainsaw that are down to where I need to chip them out now. So I'm going to kind of clean up some of the sawdust and chip these pieces out. Get rid of more wood that's not horse. Here's the biggest one over here. I'll take it out. Right back here.
Oh, you're not horse, I tell you.
I'm telling you, you want to be a part of the horse, but you're not, I promise you. Giving up little by little. Just almost out of there. Sharper, stubbornly holding on right in there. This ought to cut him. There. See there? Now see? You're not a piece of the horse. I've got you marked out. Okay, now I've cut in here, making his fetlock. This is his fetlock. I'm leaving a little extra because I'll work that down. I'll refine that with a small chisel. And after I get all of the upper part done, I'll turn it over and set it in the cradle the other way and saw then from what'll be up. I'll be sawing down into these spaces here. Looks like he's shaping up pretty good here.
Hey, Aunt Wendy called about 5 minutes ago.
Okay, I guess I better get things.
I don't think he likes being on his back too much.
No?
I've been using your little horse, Dela, kind of as a scale perspective on sizing it for a little child, and I'm hopefully going to get it about right for Mason at his age. I had thought I might put your little chair on it for safety, but Kathy said, well, no, he can hang on to that horse okay without. Leaves little marks that I have to come back and sand out by hand. Real fine sandpaper. It's just not any tool that will conform around all the shapes as well as just your hand. That worked in nice and smooth down in these little crevices. It's pretty tedious. Sander here that works fairly well. think it's 150 grit, and then emery paper. That'll put a shine on it so that when I finish it with the Watco Danish oil, it'll really have a nice shiny finish. Mason, we want your rocking horse, LaBamba, to have as shiny a coat as the model we're going from, the real jumper LaBamba that your mom won a room full of trophies and ribbons with. So I've used 60 grit coarse sandpaper, and then 80 grit, and now I'm down to fairly fine grit 100. Then I'll go to steel wool. So we'll work on this down a little here, get this coat nice and smooth. I'm reinforcing the rocker with steel plates, which will be laminated between the layers of locust wood. One on each side with wood laminated over each side then. So that should make it plenty strong for the purpose. Here's the other side of the rocker showing the steel reinforcement, which will be laminated in between the two layers of locust wood.
Major carvings have to have a heart in them, and this will be the one for LaBamba. It has a little mustard seed in it, representing faith as a mustard seed. And so this will be his heart, and I have prepared a place for it right up in there. And it's in there now. We put some glue on this peg. Smooth it in a little here. A little bit more maybe. I want his heart to get away. And we plug it right in there. Okay, he has a heart. Now I've got to fasten him down here so that he won't move around when I'm trying to work on him. This has been working pretty good. Well, I'm ready to start working on the head now. Kathy's going to be painting the fence while I'm working on the head. Hope to have this done before we leave. Only got 11 more days, well, 10 and a half now, to get this project done before we leave. Well, Mason, here's your Gigi painting your fence, your jump fence that LaBamba is going over. Isn't this neat? I like it. I think you will too.
Well, I made this mechanism in the rocker part to help him rock more smoothly. These two wheels, one spring-loaded outward to one side and the other spring-loaded outward to the other side, so that they will not only spring inward and outward, but also pivot back and forth. Also, I took this bicycle inner tube and fitted it around the bottom of the rocker in order to give Mason a little smoother ride. I don't want him to feel like he's riding a bronco. Well, here he is, LaBamba, ready to be assembled into his rocker. And here's his rocker and his fence to be jumping over. So now, here he is, complete, assembled, LaBamba, going over his jump fence.
Just sing a song.